It's great to see you. We do have this very hopeful news, John Hope Bryant, about a vaccine. The question is whether it should change the dynamic around more stimulus. We do now have a light at the end of the tunnel. Does it change for you?
It should change in Washington, but the question is whether we are about me or about we. If it's a conversation about me, then the debate and the arguments that are really locking up Washington, keeping them from seeing that this is necessary for our business plan, will continue and confidence will erode. If it's about we, i.e., after the Great Depression, the New Deal, after World War II, the new Marshall Plan, then folks will come together and see that we need to stop the bickering and get on with a business plan, because a vaccine for my small businesses actually looks like cash flow, looks like some short-term stimulus. They need to pay rent and mortgages right now. So yes, I'm hopeful, but it depends on what happens in the next few weeks, in my opinion.
Kevin, I know that you have been against more stimulus, but I would argue to you before it might have looked like a bridge to nowhere. Now it might be a bridge to somewhere. Is your view different?
No, it isn't. At this point, given that we now have a firm timetable between therapeutics and a combination of vaccines, you have to make the assumption as an investor that probably 50% of the population will be inoculated by the end of December next year. And you have to start preparing as an investor towards that. What I would like to see is zero PPP, no more for businesses. And let me clarify that. That's different than providing unemployment insurance to the massive shift. Because I believe 20% of small businesses are going to fail in the next year, not because of the pandemic, it's because consumer preferences have changed in many, many sectors. And we can't guess who the winners and losers are. So to cushion the blow to the employees, I don't care what sector you want to pick, the airline industry, the cruise line industry, the movie theater chains, who cares? The point is, those employees that are being displaced, yes, let's provide unemployment insurance for them. But $0 to the shareholders of those businesses. $0. They took the risk in the first place. The market is providing all kinds of liquidity in lenders and debt and equity. You saw the airlines go up 20% yesterday. Let them issue shares if they wish, but we're done providing free money from the sky. We don't need to. We have to let the market determine the efficiencies now by letting some assets go bankrupt and others, being managed by good managers, acquiring those assets. The PPP should be over. Zero. Done.